Hello and welcome. My name is Amulya and you are watching Is Coding. In this video, I'm going to show you how to print Fibonacci sequence in JavaScript. So this is Fibonacci sequence program that I've already written, but I'm going to write it again. And you can see I've given three arguments. So basically three, I'm trying to call the function three times with three different numbers, and each time it prints the Fibonacci sequence. So let's get started. I'm going to create a new file. So save it, fibonacci.js, and now I'm going to write a function. So it's going to be a function, also going to name it fibonacci. Hopefully you can see clearly. Fiba, and it's going to take an argument of whatever number you give it. So if you already know how Fibonacci works, then it's fine. Otherwise, this is how it works. It starts with two numbers, and to print the next number, it basically sums the last two digits in the sequence. So it will become 0 plus 1 equal to 1. This time it will sum 1 plus 1, which are just two last digits, and it will become 3. This time it will print 2 plus 1 and it will become 3. This time it will print 2 plus 3, which will become 5, and next number will become 8. So that's what we are going to achieve. And this is a repetitive task, so we are going to use this function. In the function, we are going to use for loop. So also to represent a sequence, I'm going to use array, and it is going to hold two numbers first. We do not want to move on if the number given is 1 or 2. Okay, so we just want to print these numbers. So I can simply say if n is less than or equal to 1, it's JavaScript, right? I want to console log. I want to console log fq first number, right? Similarly, if it's going to be 2, so I'm just going to put everything in just one line, right? If it's going to be 2, I'm going to change this number, console log. So this time I'm going to use spread operator, so it's going to print 1 and 2. Okay, the third is going to be, hopefully you can understand it. Now if the number, if n is greater than 2, we want to do certain things, right? We want to take the last two digits and it add to as a next number. So if it's more than 2, we are going to use a for loop. So this is for loop. I'm going to use let I equal to 1. I is less than or equal to n minus 2, because we already have n here and there are two values in it. So I'm going to just deduct those two values, and I want to n plus plus, sorry, I plus plus. Now here, this is going to, the loop is going to run for n minus 2 times, right? And each time we want to fq push So we want to take the last two numbers from the array and keep pushing. So fq plus fq, and here we are going to take last number and last second last number. So to do so, we simply say fq len minus 1. Similarly, we're going to say here minus 2. So each time it's going to take those numbers, last two digits, right? And we are done. Now we want to do console log, and using this print operator, I can simply print this number. Now let's go ahead and run this code. I'm going to use this Fiba a few times at the bottom. So basically, let's put 1, this time 2, this time 10. Okay, so let me go ahead and run the code. I'm going to save the file. Hopefully you can see it clearly now. So this is the code we have here, and we are calling this function 3 times with 3 different numbers. Now I'm going to run this code in my command prompt with Node.js. So node fiba, and you can see it's doing the same thing as above. So for given number 1, it's going to print the first number only. Given number 2, it's going to print two numbers that are already given to fq array, and then 10 times 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So it's working perfectly fine. So this is how you can print Fibonacci sequence number for a given number in JavaScript. That's it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.